Today in the news, we have a 16-core engineering sample and Windows XP. What's up, guys? I'm Snows, and this is your boot sequence. Alright, it looks like we got an update on the high-end Ryzen 3000 CPUs. A few days ago, Tom Apisak on Twitter let us know that he found some information on a 16-core Zen 2-based CPU. He told us that he would share some more details later. Well, it's been a few days, but here they are. The 16-core Zen 2 CPU, which we believe should be in the Ryzen 9 family, sports a base clock of 3.3 GHz and a boost clock of 4.2. This is quite different from what the leaks used to show, with a 3800X 16-core part having a base clock of 3.9 GHz with a 4.7 boost. Honestly, I'm not surprised. This is an engineering sample as noted by the ES and not the final product. We've spotted several engineering samples of 3rd gen Ryzen CPUs over the last few months, and all of them ran at a lower clock speed than the leaks. Plus, there's a chance that a higher core count could impact the clock speeds by a little bit. Jim from adoredTV also took part in the conversation, adding that at least two CPUs have been making the rounds with motherboard manufacturers. The 16-core that Tom found was likely one of them, and the other CPU is a 12-core with, and I quote, a really high clock speed. The second one was probably not tested online though, that's why we don't have a benchmark of it, and the last time we saw a 12-core engineering sample from AMD, the clock speeds were even lower at 3.4 GHz base and a boost clock average of 3.6 GHz. So, is AMD able to bring it all the way up to 4.7 GHz or even 5.1 as the leaks suggest? Personally, I think so. I mean, it's a long shot, but I think that when AMD chose the 7-nanometer HPC process for Zen 2 as compared to the LP process that they've been using for Zen and Zen Plus, they paved the way for much higher clocks on their CPUs. On that same Twitter post, Tom mentioned that the CPU was tested on an X570 board and that it isn't decipherable by the decode chart. He also said that he may post screenshots of his findings later. Maybe we'll get another update in the next few days. We also had a tease from MSI with their AM4 Ace gaming motherboard. This tiny video had the number 5, 6, and 7, where 6 has a little Wi-Fi symbol above it. Decoding this is pretty simple. The 6 means Wi-Fi 6 built into the board, and the 5 and 7 probably note to X570. It even glitches out showing the number 3000 for the Zen 2 series of desktop chips. Not much there, but it's a nice confirmation of what's to come at Computex. Oh, by the way, I was wondering why Tom Apisak tweeted 555. Turns out in Thai, 5 is pronounced ha, so 555 is like ha ha ha. That's pretty cool. Moving on, the Switch hacking community is going pretty nuts these days. A few months ago, we saw them scratch the surface with an almost Windows install and a GPU-less Android boot. Well, in the last few days, they've made quite the strides on that little machine. Now, Ubuntu Linux runs pretty much flawlessly on the machine. Voxel 9 also had the idea of running an OG Xbox emulator on it. Some games run pretty terribly on it, like the first Halo, struggling to maintain, you know, 12 FPS or something, but Jet Set Radio looks almost playable to me. The main issue here might be that you need a separate controller since the emulator isn't compatible with the Joy-Cons. Another hacker by the handle of DingoTech on Twitter has been pretty active running Windows XP fully on his console, but it doesn't stop there. He then ran the Dolphin emulator to play the original Wind Waker at a stable 30 FPS. He also tried the Wii emulator last month and played some Wii Sports. I mean, Nintendo hasn't ported those games, so I guess more power to him. And lastly, if you guys were looking at something fun to play this weekend, a quite bizarre mix of GOAT, Gore, and Call of Duty is going in closed beta this weekend. It's called Goats of Duty, and yeah, it looks like it might be a little fun. You can snag a beta key for free on their Discord channel, and the beta will be on all weekend until the 13th. I already downloaded it, so maybe you'll find me in there. By the way, no, they're not a sponsor or anything, I just thought it looked pretty cool. So what did you guys think of today's stories? Can AMD squeeze out more juice out of a 16-core CPU? Let me know down in the comments. I'll be there all day responding to any questions you might have. That concludes it for today's episode. Hopefully you've enjoyed. As usual, you can click right here to see the latest video, right here to subscribe to the channel. It would be greatly appreciated. Stay frosty, and I'll see you guys on the next one.
Ooh. You can click off now. The boot sequence is over.